Hey everybody, it's ZeGreatGallade and welcome back to more Super Smash Bros. Brawl, the Subspace Emissary. In the last episode, we went to the Battleship Halberd exterior and made sure that we disobeyed Snake's commands as Peach and Zelda. And we also teamed up with Fox, who initially went head-to-head with Sheik, but, you know, Peach calmed us down with some nice tea that she somehow got from nowhere when she was just sitting in the middle of the Halberd. Anyway, in this episode, we're going to go to the Battleship Halberd Bridge, because we have quite an interesting battle ahead of us, so I'm hyped. And here we are with quite an interesting boss battle, one of my, not personal favourites, but when I first played this game, I had a very difficult time with this boss for whatever reason. But anyway, we have Meta Knight who's not joining us, but Falco seemingly out of nowhere just comes and joins us, and we have Snake and Lucario here to back us up. So obviously we're going to go with the people who we least prefer. So we're going to go Peach, Sheik, Snake, and Falco. Jeez, what a lineup. Alright, anyway, so here we are with the Duon. So this thing, it's got two halves to it. One is more of a melee half. That'll attack you head on. And one's more of a range slash projectile half. Which you'll be able to tell when we see some of its attacks. So this thing, it's got homing rockets, which you can actually direct back into the boss itself to take out quite a reasonable chunk of it, but the melee half is by far the most annoying in my opinion, or not annoying, but most dangerous. But let's counter those because yeah, I feel like the melee half does a lot more damage compared to the range half, and you're gonna avoid a lot of the range half's attacks, whereas with well, except the range has some melee, but yeah, as long as you dodge consistently and you time it well, you should be able to get out of any attack, really. But yeah, there are some plentiful items. Actually, not really. There's like a moderate amount of items, but nothing too difficult. I don't know why I had so much trouble on my first time. Maybe it's because I wasn't like a seasoned Smash player, and like Subspace Emissary was the first thing that I did. But there goes Peach. We're going to have Sheik here to finish it off. We're just going to throw the smart bomb, which doesn't activate EQ. Well, thank you for blowing up on me. Anyway, let's get this Waddle Dee trophy, and we're done here. With Meta Knight back in control, and Peach seemingly, okay, I'm not gonna go there. Anyway, with that, we have our stage clear, and we just got Waddle Dee only, so with that, we have had Mr. Game & Watch join our team. It didn't really specify too much about him, but oh well. And now, what are we on? We're on 4.5 minutes. That's fine, and we can do another one. So good luck not 100%ing that, because I don't think there's a way not to. Maybe if you don't pick up the collectible that the boss drops? I have no idea. Anyway, we are now going to go into the Subspace Bomb Factory. This music is very interesting. But Samus and Pikachu are running away from something. But what? Well, obviously, actually, no. If there's an alarm, they're obviously trying to escape. Everybody, derp, derp, derp. This level is, interesting. There's a lot of exploring to be done in this level. There's a lot. There are a lot of rooms here, so you will be spending quite a bit of time if you want 100% everything and check every room for what's up, which I probably will do. Like, there's a collectible here with a lot of food, but all these rooms have a lot of enemies in them. So just pick up this food. There are quite a few collectibles to obtain here, so it's definitely worthwhile to check all these rooms. There we go. Quick work of these glunders. This song reminds me of like a Game Boy song. I don't know, it just has that little feel to it. But anyway, in this area we have a door here, which throws us into a locked battle. And it may look like we're actually progressing on, but in actuality, once we finish this battle, that was a combo and a half. Combo into the Rob launches of rocket. Let's just eat a spicy curry. There we go. We will actually discover that this is a interesting room. Ooh, I can actually make this hothead massive. Oh well, anyway, we got a soccer ball trophy, and we have some stickers over here. And yeah, this is just completely a collectible room. So, might want to make note of that. Because initially I avoided this room, and didn't end up coming back to it on my first time playing. But yeah, we just got a Warburus there and a Jike. Down here, we have a Rotoret and another Borborus. Am I saying that correctly? I always forget these things' names. Yeah, Borborus. Good. I'm surprised I remember it for once. Alright, just spawn another one, why don't you? Nice. Samus has got a really powerful down... down tilt. No, not tilt. Down air. So that's as low as we can go. We have a couple bomb heads here. But we have an entirely different section here. We have a big Primid, which I think another one should be spawning. Yes. There we go. Take quick care of those. Got some spicy curry. And now we enter into this area. I believe that is the way we're supposed to go. So if we come over here, seemingly pointless room. But if we hit that switch, we can enter this magical door, which empties us into this room with an arm ank, which you can actually make extremely quick work of as long as it doesn't close its machine or shell. And from that, we got a little hop-hip trophy. Let's climb the ladder all the way back up. Re-enter this floating door. And I think that's all the collectibles for this part. I might want to check a little more. But in here, we're going to have to deal with another Rotoret with a Jike cycling through here and there. Damn it, he actually hit me. This Jike is... Oh my goodness. Wow, I'm getting comboed from the Jike. Rotoret to Jike, true combo. Are there even true combos in Smash? In Brawl, that is. There probably is. Oh my goodness. Thank goodness for teching that. No, I meant to go up. Can I go up? Thank you. One more. Oh, actually two more, it seems. And here we have this Jike, I swear to God. There we go. Open that up. Grab two stickers. And get hit. Man. And over here, we just have a couple of Robs. Which, will they give us anything? Yes, another secret door. See, this level is full of secrets, so make sure you do check out everything. We have, ooh, the Dragon Valu from Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker. Now we're going to have to wall jump a little bit. Actually, hold on, I can do this. If we wall jump, there we go. Going to have to take a bit of effort. And here we have a music CD. Nice. Get to listen to some tunes at the end of the level. Oh, I love that. Oh, jeez, this guy's got some speed. behind these are actually a couple of Nagagogs. So just keep smashing them and you'll instantly beat them, because as long as they're hit stunned, they won't be able to grow into the massive beings that they are. Now, where's the door? I believe it's this one. Yes. On a staggering 294%, we continue down here to get killed by a robber launcher. You know, I was kind of expecting that, but oh well. Okay, just it throws us over the pit into a locked battle here with a couple Rob Sentries and a couple Rob Blasters. Can I use my C-Stick properly? Thank you. There we go. Oh, sticker. I'll take that. Yeah, so basically you'd have to just run along this platform with this. There's nothing to it. But as we can see from the rays of light, this is going to be our exit to the level. Interesting. It seems as if the ancient minister had some kind of expression of regret. Alas, with that we have our stage clear, and with that we got the soccer ball, the hoppip, Valoo, and sticker wise we got Skull Kid from The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask, Entei from Pokemon, Junior from Donkey Kong Jr., and Brighton from Mario Party 6, Super Baby from Yoshi's Island DS, Hoofa from DK Jungle Beat, Bowser from Mario Kart 64, and the title theme from Kid Icarus. Nice. And that is a solid 100% completion on the Subspace Bomb Factory. And you know what? Third time, let's just do a third level because we're only up to 11 minutes. And you know, I'm thinking of getting a couple long episodes, even though last episode was a little shorter. Let's reward your time viewing this with a longer episode. So here we are going to go into the second Subspace Bomb Factory because there are two. I don't know why they couldn't just say Subspace Bomb Factory Part 2 or something, I don't know. I mean, it's the same place, so... Anyway, I'm just blubbering on here. Let's choose from... Oh dear, I'm gonna have to use Olimar. Oh no. Alright, let's go. But there are some pretty cool music here to boot. Actually, first off, I probably want to get my 6 Pikmin. I'm used to Olimar only having 3, thanks to Smash 4 and that little nerf. Are there any collectibles down here? No, there's not. They like to hide some collectibles in those boxes sometimes, so always worth checking here and there. Speaking of, actually, I don't think there's any collectibles in this box here. Who knows? There may be. Alright, there's definitely not going to be anything here. Got to avoid these Jikes, Rob Launcher, with, oh god. Alright, want to be careful of that. There goes a couple Pikmin. I'll get them back. There we go. Oh, we got a couple purple ones too. We're gonna inflict some heavy damage. Oh, there goes a yellow. I hate how these things home on me. But at least they do despawn when the Rob Launcher tries to shoot another one. So, dang it, I threw that the wrong way. Uh-oh. Alright, can I pick up the Sky Sakari? Because that will definitely help. Oh, thank you for the saving me platform. Alright. Oh, these auto lances, they have like super armor. I mean, as do these. Oh, and these things also have projectile reflection on, like they're wearing permanent Franklin badges. This is not a good combo, Spicy Curry. Thankfully, they do not reflect my Pikmin. So, yeah, I guess these things actually don't count as a projectile. But anyway, on this platform, we have a secret room, which will give us 2 blue boxes containing one with a trophy, ooh, Kirby, like, wing form, I believe that is, and 2 maximum tomatoes, which are needed quite badly. They'll put us down to 32%. Quite healthy again. Now we're going to go back into the door and proceed on. We're going to kill this oh, no, it's going to simultaneously... Yeah, I don't want to make any more simultaneous puns. Yeah, see what I did there? Oh, I'm... That's... Oh, no, I survived! I was going to say that's what I get for making a pun, but no. Still good. Alright. So here we are onto these, the second part of the level, which is quite an interesting... It's got quite an interesting gimmick. I keep getting baited by these things, but we want to just Really, that hitbox is massive. But the gimmick of this part is that there is a door which requires three switches to be hit. So if we go up here, we can chase after the first one. But we're going to have a couple of mites in our way, which is alright. But if we hit this red switch, we want to move pretty quickly because we have this ceiling that's with spikes being crushed on us. As you can see here, we have the red one lit. And now we're going to have to find the green one and the blue one. So let's just go over here to find the green one, avoiding all these enemies, the pop ants, the buckets, and a pretty simple one down here. Actually, let's refresh on Pikmin real quick. There we go. I thought I didn't have six. I thought I had five, actually. Ouch. Why would you do that to me? I mean, I know you're trying to... Oh, my goodness. Can you leave me alone? Or, you know, kill me. That works, too. And, oh, no. I'm as Donkey Kong. That's not a good thing. I mean, for right now, it is, because I'm just going to one-hit all of these flows. And this Armite's going to have nothing on me either. And we're getting an extra life here, which is a good thing, because over here we have our blue switch. But those mites fell down from a pretty interesting spot, because if we go up here, there's a secret door here. But because Donkey Kong has absolutely no vertical jump, we cannot get up here. So thankfully that extra life will allow us to suicide and get up there as Diddy Kong. And there we go. So this is quite a secret area, but it's kind of foreshadowed earlier, if you can see along the thing. Okay, wall jumping is very ineffective. I mean, for the first couple ones, oh my goodness, can I please get up here? There we go. That'll reveal a blue box containing a trophy with something from Kirby, I think it was, and a gold box containing a star rod, also from Kirby. Nice. Alright, but yeah, this is that little area which you probably would have seen. I'll probably show it in editing right now when we passed it just a couple minutes ago, so a very subtle thing that can be easily overlooked with the objective in mind. But now that we've hit all three switches, this door is unlocked. That'll take us to this area. Okay, well, we got more collectibles to get. It's easy to tell that there's something above these little fire bars here, but we can't exactly get up here, so we're gonna have to find another way around. If we hit these switches, that'll actually activate these things, but if we go up even further, we see that there's something up there. But how on earth do we get there? Well, we don't die. We climb up this ladder. Camera, please pan. And what does this switch do, actually? Oh, leave me alone. There we go. Gonna hit this switch. Okay, that's gonna activate something we need for later on the level. That's not good. Die. Thank you very much. Gonna hit this switch, and that will disable these this fire for a little while, allowing us to get this golden box containing something. I'm assuming that's from Pikmin, because it looks very Pikmin-esque. Can I get back up? No. Camera, please pan. The camera in this game is very finicky, and I'm not a fan of it. Thankfully, the switch stays down permanently, and that'll allow us to just run past this Biton. I did not want to do that, because if we use that little launcher thing, we're going to get hit by the fire. So we want to hit that switch to disable it, and that'll lead us over here to this platform. We've got to deal with a couple of Bitons. There we go, just smash attack him a couple times. But we'll be put into a lock battle with a couple of fire primids. It's kind of, I don't know, I don't know why they don't have red portraits opposed to just the default Primid. What? I just threw that up. I didn't mean to actually kill him. Alright, but we're just going to wait a little bit. Going to come up here, head up this ladder. Is there anything off to this side? Yes, there is, actually, quite required part. If we break this block, we're going to get access to a key. Going to run past that large Biton. Open this door, and lead us to the end of the level. Say hello to Rob. So it seems as though the ancient minister was a Rob the entire time, and he felt regret and remorse for what he was doing by assisting what seems like Bowser and Ganondorf in taking over the world with the subspace. This plot is still really weird, but alas, we have a new character here, a newcomer to Super Smash Bros. Brawl, Rob. So, oh man, we're gonna have to use bad characters again. Can I select Olimar, please? There we go, Olimar, Donkey Kong, and then Samus. Oh, this is gonna be a train wreck. Anyway, Rob, quite an interesting character here. But this is going to be one of those levels where we're just going to have to kill enemies upon enemies. So, but Robbie's quite a... he's a light character. He focuses primarily on melee-type moves. His neutral special consists of a laser that gets powerful with time. So there's a bit of recharge on it, because if I use it now, it won't be as powerful. Yeah, you can't spam it, because the range will drop considerably. His side special is, I don't know what you call it, but he becomes like a spinning top almost, which deals quite a bit of damage actually. It reminds me of Pit's side special in Brawl, at least, because it was changed in Smash 4. His down special consists of winding up this little thing here, which you can actually use as a projectile, and you actually pick it up and throw it back down, and it's quite good for competitive play, because like having projectiles and keeping your spacing is always very, very important. But this bunny hood is actually going to help me a lot here, especially with this invincibility. And his final special is his up special, which is sort of like a levitation type of thing. But yeah, you can, once you activate it, you can actually hover for a while, for as long as his hover will remain. So it's actually a very good recovery as well. So he's quite a good character. I think he's just outclassed by a lot of other characters in this game, but I think he gets a lot better in Smash 4, just because of the mechanics that Smash 4 has to offer. So, let's just use this beam sword and get rid of all the Nagagogs, because if we keep just spamming them, they will not be able to grow and do more damage, but they just killed me just then, so that's alright. Yeah, as long as we keep stunning them. Uh-oh. Alright, let's just... there we go. Easy work. Couple of Auroras here. That's fine. There we go. Get rid of... oh, Beam Primers. Let's fight Beam Sword with Beam Sword. There we go. My Beam Sword's better than yours. A righteous blue Beam Sword. Speaking of which, I saw Star Wars Rogue One like a couple of weeks ago. And I do have to say... definitely not getting a sequel. Oh god, that's so bad. But it was quite a good movie. I enjoyed it thoroughly. But you know, it's kind of nice to see that they're caring about little, since the story is set in between episode 3 and 4. But yeah, it's a very nice show. It's a very nice movie. So if you have the time, go and watch it. Very good. A Star Wars fan will definitely love it. Seems as though Rob's feeble efforts to stop the Rob army from continuing to detonate the subspace bombs has failed, and we have no other choice but to escape. So, oh, damn, I have to do it again. Olimar, DK, Samus, Rob. All right, but this music, I think this is probably some Metroid, yeah, actually, no, it is Metroid, but I think it might be the same song that you use, that is played when you're escaping in like one of the Metroid games. I haven't played a single Metroid game. I apologize to all the Metroid fans out there, because from what I've heard, it's a very good series. But yeah, I've actually never played a Metroid game. Which is quite sad, honestly. But anyway, we're just going to have to keep running through this. I do not want this, actually. There we go. Get on this platform. Yeah, you can definitely tell it's a Metroid song from this type of tune. But we're going to have these these spiked walls closing in on us. Similar to what the Glacial Peak level was like. Well, yeah, as long as we just keep in the center and adapt to whatever is being thrown at us, then we should be fine for the most part. But man, this music is really funky. I like it. Metroid has a very nice music. And yeah, but we're going to have to just... Actually, if we just avoid all these simuls, but we have these platforms, which are slowly... Actually, if we just linger off to the side, we'll be fine, yeah. Ooh, I almost just died there. But yeah, that's one phase or part done. But this part, if you remain on a platform, the bombs will actually run towards you, or not run, but like move towards you, trying to attack you. But as long as you keep strafing side to side, you'll be fine. Is there anything of nothing of importance right there. Please move. Alright. Oh, there's a heart container that I might want there. Actually, I'm going to die. Okay, you know what? Stuff the heart container. We got a subspace wormhole. I found the official... CD! Oh, yes, more music. But yeah, I found the official name for those. Subspace wormhole, those things are called. Let's just get more Pikmin while we're at it. And this is going to be our exit to the level. And the music stops. And you have that little reverb, which you just hear right here. It's also very... I don't know, this reverb is very creepy in a way. More like the calm before the storm. Say hello to Meta Ridley. He's come back and he's rearing to go. He wants revenge for what Samus and Pikachu did to him. So once again, we're going to go with Donkey Kong, Samus, and Rob. And we actually have a time limit in this boss fight. So if we don't beat Meta Ridley in 2 minutes, then we are all screwed. Not just by Meta Ridley, but by the subspace bomb itself. So... stakes are high in this battle, but nothing to worry about because Meta Ridley, he stays on a pretty good portion of the ship for a long time because depending on what his health is, he'll actually remain further and further away. So if you can time how much damage you do to him at once, then you can make pretty decent work of this fight because towards the lower parts of his health, he starts remaining... like on the outside of the ship, which sometimes it's kind of hard to hit him depending on which character you're using, but for the most part it's very, very easy. We should be able to do this in under a minute if he'll come back or not. Alright, that was pretty pathetic estimation, but this move right here, you want to take, oh damn it, I wasn't fast enough, but yeah, you want to make sure you hit him a couple times because he's going to pull down the ship and end up destroying you, but with one with a meteor smash. That's a good way to end him off with a meteor smash, but there goes Meta Ridley, and we've made it safely out. And with that, everyone has united. It seems as though we're getting to the climax of the game. Slowly but surely, we're getting there. Anyway, with that, we have our stage clear. Wing Kirby, Bomber, Star Rod, and the Fiery Blowhog. Yeah, I was right in saying that was from Pikmin. And sticker-wise, you got Moon Fairy Saren from Nintendo Puzzle Collection, Midna and Wolfling from The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, Master Belch from Earthbound, Fairy Bottle from Twilight Princess, and Kumatora from Mother 3. And we got the Golden Forest 180 Snowboarding. I like it. With that, we have Rob on our team, and yeah, those couple. What was that accent? Make sure you do collect everything, because there's a point of no return. So we won't be able to play those levels. Spoiler alert: you will once you beat the game. But yeah, if you want to get 100% completion on your first time through, make sure that you get everything, and just take care when collecting or going through the level, because, yeah, we no longer have access to any of those levels because they've all been sucked up by the subspace. But anyway, that's going to be it for this episode. Man, we got a lot of stuff done. Jeez, a solid 30-minute video. You guys will like this. But, yeah, next time on the Subspace Emissary of Super Smash Bros. Brawl, that was a weird order of saying that, we're going to go into the entrance to the subspace. Seems as though now that we've all congregated into one massive group, we're going to tackle the main problem at hand, the subspace, Ganondorf, Bowser, and Master Hand. So, this is getting awesome. Alright, so if you did enjoy this video, please rate, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter for more updates. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!